Hi, in this video we'll start using Scratch to further deepen our understanding of the principles of programming. First of all, to be able to create programs using Scratch, we need a platform that allows us to do that. In other words, we need something similar to Replit that we used in the previous video series to write programs in the C language, but this time for Scratch. To access the web-based Scratch platform, we need to go to www.scratch.mit.edu. On the screen you can see the main page of the Scratch platform. You can stop the video and take a look at the programs other people have created using Scratch here on the main page. To create our own program, we need to press the Start Creating button here, and it will take us to the actual programming environment. Now, before we actually start making anything with Scratch, let's familiarize ourselves with the interface. First of all, let's look at these three tabs. The first one is the Code tab. Here you can see the building blocks that you can use to create programs. The next tab, Costumes, allows you to choose and modify the images of the characters you use in your program. The last tab, Sounds, allows you to add sounds to your program and modify them. Let's go back to the Code tab. This white area to the right of the coding blocks list is where we will create our programs by adding blocks to it. To add a block to the program, click on it and drag it to the code area, like this. Next, in the top right corner is the area where you will see the result of running the program you have created. Currently, we have the default cat character. Now, if you click the move block that we added a few moments ago, you will see the cat move, just as the name of the block suggests. Here, at the top, we have two buttons. The green flag button is the start button that you can use to, surprise, surprise, start your program. Right next to it is the stop button that you can use to stop your program. Here is the Sprite Properties panel that displays the name of the sprite, its X and Y positions, size, direction, and whether the sprite is visible or not. Before we move on, for those of you unfamiliar with the word sprite, a sprite is just an image, in our case an image representing a character. Below the Properties panel is the list of sprites that you have in your program. You can add new sprites by clicking the Add button in the bottom right corner, like this. And you can remove sprites by clicking the Trash Bin button in the top right corner of the sprite, like this. Finally, this narrow area at the very right is the stage settings where you can see the current background or backdrop as it's called in Scratch. You can add more backdrops by clicking the Add button here. Note that if you click inside the backdrop area, the list of available blocks in the Code tab will change, and the caption of the tab right next to the Code tab will change from Costumes to Backdrops. In the Backdrops tab, you can also add backdrops, in addition to removing them by pressing the Trash Bin button and modifying them here in the editor. Now we're going to create a very simple program that makes our character move. First of all, let's be more creative and change our character. Let's add one of the sprites that Scratch has by default. To do that, we need to click the Add button here. Let's choose this cute beetle. Now we have two characters, the cat and the beetle, but we only need one, so I'm going to delete the cat. Goodbye cat, nothing personal. Earlier in this video we used the move block, the very first one on the list of available blocks. One important detail is that the code you build belongs to a specific character, or sprite, meaning the move block that we added previously belonged to the cat character and was deleted when we deleted the character. The character whose code you're dealing with at the moment is displayed in the top right corner of the code area, here. So to have our new character move, we need to add the move block to the code area again. Let's click the block. Our character has moved a bit. Let's look at the move block. It says move 10 steps. Some of you have probably figured that the number of steps can be changed. Let's change it to 50 and see what happens. Our character moves forward in larger steps. But what exactly is a step in Scratch? Let's look at the Properties panel, specifically at the part that displays the X and Y position of the character. If you click the move block again while looking at the X position of the character, you will see that it gets increased exactly by the number of steps you specified in the move block. In other words, a step is a distance unit in Scratch, and the position of a character on the screen is also specified in steps. We can modify the position of the character by directly changing its X and Y coordinates in Properties. Let's set our character's position to 0, 0. As you can see, 0, 0 is the coordinates of the center of the screen. You can also change the position of a character by dragging it around using the mouse, like this. Let's now move our character to the bottom left corner using the mouse. Now let's set the number of steps in the move block to 400. If we click the block now, our character will move to the bottom right corner of the screen. Now let's have the character move back to where it was. How do we do this? We can add another move block and set the number of steps to -400. If we click the second move block, the character indeed moves back to where it was. But it moves backwards, which isn't the best way of moving. Let's click the first move block to have a character move to the bottom right corner again. Let's now have our character turn around before it moves back to the starting point. We can change the direction of the character's facing here in properties. Currently, our character's direction is set to 90. Let's change it to 0. We also need to make sure its rotation is set to all around, like this. So 0 means that the character is facing north. 90, the original value, makes the character face the east, 180, the south, and -90, the west. Let's set our character's direction back to 90. To change a character's direction in code, we can use one of the turn blocks that you can find right below the move block. There are turn clockwise and turn counterclockwise blocks. Let's drag the turn clockwise block to our program. If you want our character to turn around, how many degrees should it turn? Did you say 180? You're right. Now, if we click the turn block, our character turns around. Great. Currently, we have two move blocks. One says move 400 steps, the other one says move -400 steps. Which one do we use to make our character move back to the bottom left corner? Since our character now faces the direction it needs to move in, we should use the move 400 steps block. We no longer need the move -400 steps block, so let's remove it from our program. To remove a block, we need to drag it back to the blocks list, like this. We can now have our character move back and forth using the move and the turn blocks. However, the way it is now, it can hardly be called a program because we need to click each block to make our character move. Let's now try to snap the two blocks together to have the character turn around right after it moves without waiting for us to click the turn block. Before we do that, let's move our character back to the bottom left corner using the move and turn blocks. Now let's grab the turn block and drag it to the bottom edge of the move block until we see the gray shade. Now if you release the mouse, the turn block will snap to the bottom of the move block. If you click this group of blocks now, the character will do both move and turn. The movement, however, doesn't really look smooth. Our character rather teleports than moves. We're going to fix that in the next video, but you're more than welcome to explore and try to figure out how to make the character move more smoothly. The last thing we're going to do in this video is we're going to make the character move when we press the green flag button. Currently, it doesn't work. To make it work, we need to add another block. Let's scroll down to the yellow colored blocks. What we need is this one, when green flag clicked block. Unlike the move and turn blocks, this one can only be snapped on top of a block. Where do you think it should go in our program? Right, it should go on top of the move block, like this. Now every time you click the green flag button, the character will move to the other side of the screen and turn around. Cool. In this video, we created a simple program in Scratch that makes a character move back and forth on the screen, which is way more exciting than a program that prints Hello World. However, let me repeat that Scratch doesn't do anything essentially different from C that we used in the previous video series. There is no essential difference between displaying text on the screen and displaying images. It's just that images are generally more visually pleasing than text. This is not to say that Scratch is useless and that C is better than Scratch. I'm saying this so that you don't think that there is some sort of complex magic involved in making games. I'm also saying this to emphasize that making computer programs, including games, might be easier than some people think. This is it for this video. In the next one, we will continue learning programming with Scratch by creating a program that makes character move more smoothly. See you then. Bye.